So if you look at the shipbuilding industry, this industry has been early adopters of both CAD and RP for past many years, at least 40 years for CAD. But PLM or product lifecycle management is relatively new in shipbuilding. What a PLM system does is supports the collaborative creation or authoring. By authoring, in this case, you're talking about a CAD system for ship design. Then management, which is managing the data. Dissemination, disseminating the data within the shipyard and to organizations outside the shipyard. And use of the product definition information, or in our case, the ship design and the manufacturing information across the extended enterprise. The extended enterprise would include the customer class, the marine supply chain, or the specific marine suppliers, which could be even design providers for the project. PLM systems not only manage data during the design phase, they manage data for the entire life cycle of a product or a ship, starting from inquiry from a customer to design, production, or construction, in-service support and maintenance, then upgrades and refits, which is particularly important for naval shipbuilding, and right up to ship disposal. What a PLM system does is provides a framework which effectively enables capture, representation, retrieval, and reuse of product and process data or knowledge. In this case, the process knowledge would be the knowledge for ship manufacturing or construction, and allows collaboration across distributed and multidisciplinary design teams in a shipbuilding project. Since shipbuilding is a project-based industry with heavy involvement of subcontractors and suppliers who are actually spread around the globe for most projects, effective collaboration is key for success of a project. And this is what a PLM system helps facilitate. One key requirement for effective change management is knowledge capture and retrieval for the current project and the foregone projects, which again, a PLM system can handle very effectively. So a PLM system actually provides a digital thread for change management, which facilitates or allows a collaborative workflow that links processes across the shipbuilding organization. The organization for a typical shipbuilding project or a shipyard would include design, engineering, planning, production, and inventory, class, suppliers, etc. Sister ships, then different changes affecting a specific configuration of a ship and its roll-on effects. The effectivity of a change, which means which particular configuration and at what time should have that change affected. The required information or knowledge about a product and its current state to evaluate an engineering change is actually resident in different systems in a shipyard and multiple systems. And this is what a PLM system can help manage. We're talking about different configurations of ships of a class and how change propagates and affects different ship configurations, like the three examples we talked about, starting from design to manufacturing, and that can extend to ships in service. And then you will have different IT systems used in different places in the extended enterprise, and also importantly in different phases of the ship life cycle. So if you look at this particular slide, you see a major portion of the data related to the ship design or the product design is actually managed by the PLM system, which includes different configurations, different document revisions, effectivity. These are all managed by the PLM system. And the manufacturing data is actually managed by the ERP and MRP systems. So the PLM system manages the design-driven information or the product-related information and hands over or exchanges the data and information with ERP and MRP systems for production. So the PLM system enables the change to propagate throughout the life cycle of a product or a ship, making its real impact visible and measurable not only within the design organization, but also across manufacturing and other stakeholders across the extended enterprise.